Hey guys, good morning and welcome back to a brand new video. My name is Aditya Aurangi and in this video we're going to learn about sending data and receiving data in functions and a few more things. Okay, so let's start. In the previous video we saw how can we create a function. So the layout of the function, so the def keyword, then space, then name of the function, then round brackets, colon, then the statement which comes under function. So we have to write after giving four spaces or this tab key on the keyboard. Either you can press tab key or you can give four space bar. Okay, so and we learned how we can call the function by using the function name and round brackets. So in this video we will learn about how we can send data and perform operation on that data. Okay, so let me create one function which is my add. Okay, my add will add two elements. So let me give a comma b. So the value which this function will receive is a comma b. So and how can I send this value? So I have to call my function my add. And inside when I'm calling this function, I have to pass the value. Let's say 2 comma 3. And how can I do operation? Simply this 2 comma 3 value will be received in A comma B respectively. So 2 in A and 3 in B. So I have in this function, I have A comma B and I can use these variables to do anything. So I'm going to do A plus B. I'm printing A plus B. Okay, so if I run it, I get 5. Same if I pass 22 comma 13. Okay, and then A will, so let me print A, print B. Okay, so you can see here, first 22 is printed because I am printing A here. So A received 22 and then 13 is printed. B received 13 and then I am printing the addition of it. Okay, same way we can do any operation. A minus B, B star A. So A minus B 9, B star A 286. So this way we can send our data and receive it in function. So what this A and B is called and what this 22 and 13 are called in terms of Python. So A here, A and B are called parameters and 22 comma 13 are called arguments. So the value which I am sending to the function is arguments and the variables in which it is received is parameter. Okay, so keep this in mind, arguments and parameters. So parameters are means defined in the function and the arguments is the value. Arguments are the value which I am sending to the function. So I send the value when I am calling the function. Okay, now let's say I am printing the result here but I don't want my result to be printed here. I want my result to be returned to where I am calling the function. So I am calling the function in main body. So I want my result here. How can I? So I am sending my data. Then the function is processing and getting the result. Then I want the function to send me the result. How can I get the result? So for that I have one command which is return. Return. And I can do A plus B. So return A plus B, so it will give me, so this value will be replaced with A plus B. So let me do C equal to my add 22 comma 13. So how the function will run? So from top to bottom it will start. So first it will see def, then it recognizes it as a function. So it does nothing because function on its own is nothing. We have to call it. So it reads this line, first line, does nothing. Second line is a part of that function, does nothing. Third line, there is nothing, so okay, nothing. Fourth line, c equal to my at 22,13. So what it does, it calls this function my add and sends this value 22,13 to this function, my add function. So here in a 22 is received, in b 13 is received, and inside when we go, we are returning a plus b. So we are calculating here a plus b first, and then the value which is calculated is returned to the position where it was called, where this function, whole function was called. Where was it called? Here, my add 22,13. So once I'm calling this, the function is getting called, value is received in the function, it is processing, and then it's returning me the answer. So after that, this thing is replaced with a plus b, the value of a plus b, which is 35. Okay, so the value which it, the function calculated and returned, is stored in C now. Means that's how the flow of process will be, program will be, okay. So if I do this, it shows me nothing, because in the function I'm printing nothing, and in the C I've got the value, but I'm doing nothing with it. So I can do here like this, print C. Okay, so I get 35. And I can do one more thing, instead of saving it in C and then printing, I can do inside the print function, I can give the function call itself. So I'm calling the function inside print function. So when the computer reads this line, so it reads print first, then it goes inside the print bracket, there it finds the function call. So it calls the function, function processes the data which I sent, 22,13, and returns the value 35. So this whole line, my add bracket 22,13 bracket, this thing, the function call, is replaced with the return value, which is 35. So now in the end it becomes print 35 after all the calculation, and then I'm printing the value 35. See, I get 35 here. I can do one more thing, like just to show you that this is the current output, 35,8. Okay. And here also, I can do C equal to A plus B. And then instead of returning A plus B, I can return C. So, in any way it works, there are multiple ways of doing it. So, this was return keyword. One more thing about return is that the moment in a function we reach return, so everything below return will be neglected. Okay, so the moment we reach return, we return that value whatever is there and get back to the starting point. What is that starting point? This function call. This function call is the starting point, and whatever was below return is left without execution. Okay, so let me write here, print 4. Okay, so let's run it. So I get 35. So it sees this function, does nothing, get to this line, print, then goes inside, sees my add function, and data I'm sending to the my add function. My add function is called. So I'm calling this function. We are processing C equal to A plus B, then returning C. The moment return is reached, when the execution flow reaches return, so it leaves the function and get back to the starting point, which is this starting point of the function call. So I am calling the function here. This is my function call. So anything below the return statement is left out. It is not executed. Okay. So anything below this return statement is left out. So that was return statement. We can have multiple return statement in the function. So let me rename my function my big. So I want this function to return a bigger value of the one which I'm sending. So I'm sending two values, I want it to return the bigger value. So which value is big? A comma B. So let me use you know if else. So we can use if else if A is greater than B. Okay, so inside this body, if this condition is true, so if A is greater than B, if this is true, that means A is big. So I'm returning A. Else, I will return B. Okay, got it. I have multiple return statements. So whichever return we hit first, that will return the value and get back to the starting point. So if 22, 13, so 22 is bigger. So A is 22, B is 13. So A greater than B, which is true. So we go inside if condition and we return A. So when we reach this point, we are coming back to the starting point and we are skipping this part. Even the else part is skipped. Everything is skipped. Once we reach return, we come back to the starting point or to the function call, leaving everything behind it, below it. So, so before that, let me do print A, and here let me do print B. So if I run this, I get 22 twice, because when I call this function, print this, I'm going inside this, I'm calculating which is bigger, and then going inside if or else, anyone which according to the statement A greater than B. So if this time A is bigger, so we are printing A here. So first 22 is printed, returning A here. So print my big function call is replaced with print 22. So the value 22 is returned. So I'm printing 22 again. Okay. So these statements are skipped. If I gave 133, so I get 133, because this if A greater than B becomes false, because A is 22, B is 133. So we don't go inside here, and in the else part, we go inside, we print 133 and then returning 133 here, and then printing 133 again, because it's inside print function. I hope you are getting this. How we can send and how we can have multiple return values, but only one will get activated. Even if I have here return B, okay, let's skip this too. So if I have print A, then return A, return B. So I have two return statements, both will get executed. Both, if it was in the main body, both would have gotten executed. But in the function, first, when we hit first return, so everything below it gets skipped. So we return A value and then return B is skipped, because we are at the starting point function call. So print A. 22 is received in A, print A, returning A, skipping this statement. So I hope you got it.